One of my favorite things about hosting this show is that people always tell me pretty consistently that it's a very welcoming environment where people can just let their guards down. That means a lot to me. So when the idea came up that we'd do a prom episode, I was like, no way, man. Proms are terrible. They make you question everything about yourself. They make you think so hard about social standing and all this other awful stuff. Then it got me thinking, what if we threw a prom where everyone could just come in, be themselves, be who they are, want what they want, not worry about anything? Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the Chris Gethard Show.
3, 2, 1. Good evening, weirdos! Welcome to the Chris Gethard Show with sidekick Shannon O'Neill, internet liaison Bethany Hall, the feature from the sea, the human fish, the greatest house brand in the world, the LLC, from HBO's Girls, Lena and Dunham. And later on, we'll be boogieing to They Might Be Giants. Yes, I'm Murph, and tonight's my 11th prom. Here's your host, Chris Gethard!
Thank you all so much. Welcome, everybody. I'm so happy to be here. As you can see, it's a very special night. Everyone's all dressed up. It's because we're all going to prom, and not a prom like any other. This is a prom free of judgment, free of feeling bad about yourself, free of trying to fit into anybody else's boxes. It's also so important to note, it is an under-the-sea themed prom. A lot of that is because what else would it be? Another part, though, is our very special guest here tonight expressed a desire to play a mermaid, so it only made sense. Lena Dunham, thank you for joining us here at the Chris Gethard Show. You look
so
wonderful.
Thank you. Yeah. This is so wonderful and such an honor, and I did not know that my request would be granted in such a beautiful and open-hearted way.
Are you? How do you feel locking into mermaid mode after all this time?
I have to say, it's so natural.
Yeah.
It's so natural for me. I've always felt very mermaidish inside, and yeah. So to get to express that on my outsides tonight, I also have to note, like, I don't like to move. So a to be carried by a couple of gentlemen to a chair, which will then be wheeled around by someone who's not me, is all I've ever wanted.
Yeah, it's wonderful. You're wearing it well with such an air of confidence.
Thank you so much.
Shannon O'Neill also embracing your inner turtle tonight.
Thank you very much.
Yes. How you feeling? Well, tonight's prom, I feel like when I think about prom, for a lot of people, it's a really romantic thing. It goes well. For a lot of people, I bet it brings up a lot of anxiety, self-questioning, maybe puts them under a microscope they're not in the mood to be under at that time in their life. Tonight, we're going to try to erase all those problems as we throw the world's first under-the-sea, gender-fluid poly prom. While tonight's prom here is very accepting, there are real proms taking place all over the world in this time of year, and we are going to involve some of them. This is totally true. We have a number of people who are going to call and Skype tonight who, on the air, are going to ask out a real-life prom date. We're going to talk to them a little bit. I want to say that I'm willing to wingman anybody. Shannon, Lena, I don't know if you'd be down, but we can feel these people out, and if we want to endorse them...
Yeah, if I think that they're sending out good, non-destructive energy, I'll wingman them. Yeah. But if I feel like someone's going to... go, you know, be inappropriate with their prom date or do something that could be emotionally destructive, I'm not gonna be helpful.
So you're gonna call it like you see it.
Yeah.
All right, so callers, get ready for some tough love, some honest truth. Bethany, how are you?
I'm great, Chris. I'm the ocean.
Oh, you are the ocean, the living embodiment of the ocean tonight.
Yes, and this is my date.
Oh, your date is a balloon.
Wow.
Look at that. Well, that's fantastic. All right, do we have anybody on Skype, on the phone? What are we looking at?
We do. Let's talk to Dan from California.
Dan from California, welcome to the show.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm feeling really good tonight. You're looking for a prom date?
That's true.
So you're going to ask someone live on the air tonight?
Yes.
Okay.
Dan, are you a senior in high school?
Yes, I am.
Cool. You have a very mature energy, so I was just making sure there wasn't a catfishing situation.
No catfish.
I feel really good energy coming from you, and I also think you've got a distinctive look, and those are two of the things that I'd be wanting in my prom date.
Excellent.
I also think this is a bold way to ask out your prom date, so I want to give you applause on that, Dan.
Thank you.
Any prom date would be impressed. Any prom date should be impressed by that.
Thanks. Who are they? Do we get to ask who they are?
Let's do it. Let's ask them out.
Well, you want me to ask her right now?
I think so, if you're down.
Okay.
Can I ask one question really fast,
Dan? One quick question.
Yes.
Does asking someone to prom mean that you definitely think you guys are going to make out and have sex? Or is it more like just like we're going to hang and it could be friendly?
Great question. Great question.
Well, for most people, it means like, yeah, we're gonna have sex. But for me, I don't know. I'm just not into that. You know, that's just not me.
Wow. What a sensitive, thoughtful answer. All right. So, Dan, let's do it. Let's send the message out there. I hope that our work here tonight helps. We think you have a positive energy. We think you're bold. You're brave.
Thank
you. I hope your prom date responds.
I agree.
Do it.
Okay. Okay, this one goes out to Alexis. I just think you're really cool. You're really fun. I like being around you. You're super pretty. And it would be my pleasure if you would go with me to prom.
All right. Alexis, if you're out there, if you see this, embrace Dan. That was so sweet. Alexis could not make a better choice.
I have something to say to Alexis.
Yeah, Bethany.
If you don't go to prom with Dan, I'm going to.
Wow.
Yeah! I have such a crush on Bethany also.
Well, Dan, good luck with Alexis. Let us know how it goes. And Alexis, if you're out there, if you're watching, if you want to respond, call in. We'll hook it up. We'll make it happen. Whatever we can do.
And if you want to have sex with Dan, we could probably talk him into it.
Okay. Bethany, who's up next?
All right, let's talk to Olivia from Michigan.
Oh, Olivia from Michigan. Woo! How are you?
Hi, Olivia.
Hi.
Okay, so is this a junior prom, a senior prom? What are we looking at?
Senior and junior, but my school is really small. Uh-huh. So there's like the entire high school.
Okay, so this is an entire high school event. We're here for you. Right off the bat, I'm going to say you seem very nice. I hope you're not nervous because we're here to have your back.
Cool.
That was the answer of a person who sounds nervous, I will say. So you're asking someone out, how can we help? How can we be of service?
Well, he just texted me and he said this is the strangest thing he's ever seen.
He's watching right now? And he thinks our show is the strangest thing he's ever seen.
Did you tell him to watch, or is he a regular viewer?
I told him to watch.
So he's watching. He thinks this show is the strangest thing he's ever seen. He obviously knows you. That means he could text you right now because he knows the cat's out of the bag. This means you have effectively already asked out your prom date. Wow. So what's his first name? Olivia, what's his first name?
Ethan.
Ethan?
Ethan, that's such a nice name. Biblical, attractive.
You should text Olivia right now, say, we're going to do this. I'm taking you to prom. Sounds awesome. What a badass way to ask me out. Let's do it. Anybody else have any thoughts for Ethan?
Ethan, if this is the weirdest thing you've seen, you got to watch more porn, bro.
It's true. We know Ethan's a very wholesome guy.
Yeah.
Very wholesome guy.
Olivia, I think it was so cool of you to take it into your hands, do it in a creative way, and I doubt Ethan can resist this.
Absolutely.
The only problem is that he lives 7 hours away from me.
Cars drive that far.
We can make it happen.
I have an idea. What if you guys went, if he doesn't have access to a car, you guys could also go Dutch on a train ticket, which would be very modern.
Yeah.
We live in Michigan. There's no trains here.
Oh, got it.
Fine. Then a very sad Greyhound bus. Extraordinarily sad Greyhound situation. I'll even throw in some cash on the Greyhound.
What I was about to say was that and you got ahead of me, that if Ethan says yes, the Greyhound round trip, it's on me.
Wow. Okay, if you're covering the Greyhound, I'll buy Ethan some snacks for the Greyhound.
I'll pay for that hotel room.
Whoa. The trip's on us, Ethan. Olivia, any text here? Any text from Ethan? We know, Ethan, we know you're watching. You do the right thing. This bold, brave young lady, this fierce young lady is putting herself out there in the world for you, Ethan. Anything on that phone, Olivia? Okay. Everyone quiet, quiet, please, quiet.
Oh, is it dot, dot, dot?
You got that dot, dot, dot?
You got that dot, dot, dot?
No, dot, dot, dot.
Ethan, stop typing and deleting and just commit to it.
Oh.
What's it say?
Oh, we can't read it.
What's it say? No, you're tilting it down when I'm trying to look down here. Just say it, Olivia.
Yes, 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 a million times. Yes.
Congratulations. Yay! Congratulations.
This is so fun.
Love. We just made love happen. Amazing. Bethany, we got anybody else? Anybody else?
All right, let's talk to Sam from New Jersey.
Oh, Sam from New Jersey. Welcome. Hello, Sam. So, Sam, you're here. The Chris Gethard Show cast and Lena Dunham, we're here to help you ask someone out to prom. So tell us who you want to ask out. How can we help?
I'm going to ask out best friend, Gail.
You're asking out your best friend?
That's so nice. And do you think Gail knows that you're going to ask her to prom?
I don't think she does.
And do you think that she has been nervous about, isn't this going to be such an amazing relief to her to have the joy of someone she already really cares about ask her to prom?
I think it was going to be that great because one of our friends that was supposed to be her date couldn't show.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you're here. This is already a friendship that it's been blossoming for years. And now here, when you need each other most, you're stepping up to the plate to have each other's backs.
Yeah, this is great. This is really beautiful.
I'm sorry. I'm actually asking her to her prom.
To her prom.
You're asking her to her prom.
Yeah.
Good. Go for it.
Bold. Bold.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's great.
That's cool because it's kind of like inviting yourself to a prom, which I think is awesome. Okay. Everything you're doing, we love, and I think that it's going to be a beautiful experience and that Gail would be a fool not to take you up on this opportunity.
And I'm.
She's texting me.
She's texting you right now?
What's she saying?
Is she watching?
She is.
Okay, we have another one. Can you just ask her one more time? I just want to make sure she hears it in a clear way in your voice.
Okay. Gail, my best friend for years, will you go to your prom with me?
Beautiful. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. And she's texting you right now. What are we working with here?
She's saying that she didn't get the call from you. Oh. And this would love to go to prom with me, though.
She'd love to go to prom with you. That's awesome. We were going to call her later, and I guess Gail let the cat out of the bag.
Yeah.
We were going to make it happen on the show, but modern technology, these kids today, Shannon.
They figure out faster than anybody.
Everything needs to be instantaneous.
I know.
She just Snapchat at you her answer, I guess. It went away. Fine. 6 seconds answer. Well, congratulations to you and Gail. Incredible. Well done. All right. Bethany, I'm hearing we have one more call.
We do. Let's talk to Jack from Michigan.
Jack from Michigan. Welcome
Hi,
to the
Jack.
Show. How are you doing?
I'm pretty good. Pretty nervous as well.
Okay. That's totally fine. I've been nervous. I get nervous most of every day. I'm nervous. I'm nervous most of my life. Yeah.
Nerves always means that it's important.
Yeah, that's perfectly true.
It's
Can you
thing.
Tell us a little about who you're asking and why?
Yeah, I'm asking my friend Winter. I'm a junior and she's a senior, and we became good friends over the musical and both in it this.
Okay. If anybody knows about falling in love with someone in the cast of a high school musical, it is a guy who played Moonface Martin in Anything Goes junior year. Certainly is. Yeah. Okay.
And probably you guys got really close because plays and performances in general engender a real intimacy.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to go ahead and ask you this, too. Did you normally dress so well, or did you dress up specifically for this purpose?
I dressed up specifically for the prom.
Oh, nice. Well, that speaks to your character. This young,
yep.
this person's going to feel very taken care of and safe and knows that you're a class act. That's a great thing right out of the gate.
And do you, I know I keep asking this, but I'm just curious, do you feel like the answer is yes?
Yeah, I think so.
That
I mean, I'm not positive for sure, but confidence.
No. That confidence is going to take you all the way to the bank, sir.
I can speak from experience. Guys who look like members of Weezer do better than you think. They do better than you think.
My boyfriend is a guy named Jack with glasses, and I think it's a really positive look. Name combo. Yep.
So an endorsement overall for men named Jack who have eye problems.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, well, Jack, good luck. We hope she's watching. We hope it all works out. Let us know. And I hope we help make it happen.
Thank you so much, Chris.
Good luck to you. That's awesome. It's time for our first dance. We've been standing too much. I want everybody to grab someone they have not met yet, someone you did not come here with. Let's start it up. Get us out. Let's go to commercial.
We're under the sea. I'm under the influence. Don't tell the chaperones. We'll be right back with more Chris Gethard Show. So don't swim away, little fishes.
I'm about to go be a mermaid. I love you, baby. Bye. All right.
It feels really good. I'm trying to figure out the most like elegant angle to work.
Yeah.
Like if it's more like that, or if it's more like that. Like this is what feels right to me. Do you know what I mean?
I know exactly what you mean.
Like the ones in Peter Pan.
That's exactly what I was gonna say. The sexy bitches in Peter Pan.
The sexy in Peter Pan.
I think we're all enjoying our 2016 Under the Sea Gender Fluid Poly Prom, are we not? Beautiful, that's wonderful. I do have bad news for all of us, though. We've been dancing, and we wanted to provide refreshments. This is true. All three of these punch bowls were filled. I watched them get filled earlier tonight. I was informed that someone came and dumped them out. I don't know why.
It was me!
No. Lena, I'm very sorry. This is a guy, all these people love him for some reason. He's my nemesis, Vacation Jason.
I saw him backstage and I was like, oh no.
Oh yes, all positivity, all love, all vacation vibration. Gethard, I hate you. Lena, I brought you a little apple.
Oh, thank you.
It fell on the floor. Please don't eat it. Oh my God, Chris. It's a disaster, man. Your punch was terrible.
He's negging you.
What are you talking about? We had a lot of great punch.
It looked like this. It looked like toilet water, man. Look at this. I don't want to go political, but I really do. This is sugar and high fructose corn syrup. It's messing up your brain.
You're really taking a stand, Vacation Jason. You're really a character that's earned the right to make political statements.
I am an avatar of world peace.
Okay.
Yeah. So what I got here, I thought we could make a little vacation punch with all natural ingredients.
Okay.
All you gotta do is smell this.
I just have to say it's very triggering for me to have a guy dressed like this talking about making punch.
There are some trigger warnings present in your very existence.
Yes. It's getting worse, too.
I don't feel safe.
Okay.
Whoa.
I do have to say, though, if there is one thing I trust you with, it is an ability to make punch.
Thank you.
That does seem to be in your wheelhouse.
Thank you. Yes, my wheelhouse is a boathouse.
Yes. Why did you like that joke?
Why? I don't know. I'm stressed all the time. I'm from New Jersey. Blue collar. Oh, yes.
So far, your collection of containers is sad.
Yeah. That's right, I had to move
fast.
What is that? I don't know. Let's find out. Okay, I don't like...
You say these are all natural juices that you brought.
No, this one's going in yours. I don't like that.
Is that squid juice?
That is brown water. Okay. Whoa!
Vacation, Jason. Everything does smell very good and fresh, though.
Oh, my God. Give it up for fruit, guys.
Fresh fruit. Oh. Wow.
Oh, the physical manifestation of sunlight and happiness, right?
Now, I'm assuming you didn't get these at stores. I assume these
No, this was picked from the vine. This was all...
How many different islands did you have to travel to procure that one container of fruit?
My atom split to all the islands at once and then reconvened magically with
You're saying your body dissipated into separate atoms.
Yes.
Those atoms gathered fruit.
Yes.
From around the world.
Yes.
And all met back in our studio.
Yes.
And you are now distributing that fruit here today.
Oh, I hate how you got it so right. Oh, I hate it. But I love it.
Can you guys see that those are not ice cubes? They're little...
They're bioluminescent nobules.
Wow. Yeah. So stressful.
Yes.
Okay, so okay. I personally will not be having any of this punch.
Okay.
Does anybody
neither.
In the room want to try Vacation Jason? Wow, a lot of people do.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, yeah. I was told that when you dumped our punch, you also threw out all our glasses.
Yeah.
Is this true?
Yes, I got something better.
Okay, I'm listening. I'm all
better
here.
Better than glasses.
No!
I'm gonna spray it in people's mouths!
Okay, does anyone still want this punch?
Yeah.
Okay, anyone who wants it, please gather up here. Let's everybody else clear out. If you want the punch, go up here. No one with food allergies can do this. Know that this will ruin your clothes. Lena, any desire to spray punch into people's mouths?
Yes.
Okay, so even though morally you're against it.
Even though, here's why I'm comfortable. I watched it get made. Okay. I want to spray punch into the mouth of the other mermaid named Lena.
Okay, there's another mermaid named Lena also here tonight. You're going to aim specifically for her is
okay.
what I'm hearing.
How
I'll help refill your gun.
How close do I get?
And that's a good distance. That's a good distance for camera. Welcome to the first ever Under the Sea Gender Fluid Poly Prom. Very, very happy to have you guys here. Thanks for watching. Thank you, Lena Dunham, for hanging out.
It's an honor.
Helping us so
much. It's an honor.
I think everybody's having fun. And I wanted to just say, too, that part of the whole point of this prom is that you won't be judged. You can live whatever lifestyle you want. And I think regular proms are often horror stories for people because I think a lot of times you have to fit into some binaries that maybe aren't natural. I think maybe sometimes you're just a little not confident. We wanted to invite people to maybe get some of those prom stories off their chest. So we have a number of people here who had really bad prom experiences who are going to come up, slow dance with Lena Dunham, get their story off their chest by speaking to this microphone while they do. It's going to look like this. You'll just go by the hands,
yep.
Position yourself in front of the microphone.
Thank you for guiding them, because it would have been
course.
So uncomfortable to
so
have to
awkward.
Be like... remove someone's hand from a place I didn't
of
want it.
Of course. Nobody get handsy in a weird way.
No, this is so nice. This is what slow dancing should be.
Yes. With a microphone delineating a comfort zone between you.
Yep.
And that will be that.
I want to go back to the good old days when teachers came and put like boards between you and were like, this is how close you can get, young man.
Yeah. Now I don't think it's like that at all.
Now it's just a grind-a-thon free-for-all.
I think we are living in the age of grind-a-thon free-for-alls. I know I'd be shocked if one did not erupt in this studio by the end of the night. Let's go ahead. Who's our first person? Hello, sir.
Hi.
Please welcome.
So nice to meet you.
It was the first slow dance, and I got an erection. And the girl I was dancing with noticed and left the dance floor and left me on it by myself.
I'm by yourself with your erection?
Yes, yes, yes.
How quickly did it go down?
I don't remember.
I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
Well, I bet if you got erect respectfully here, people would be fine with it.
Thank you so much, sir. Do you feel better?
Yes, I do.
Thank
Great.
You.
Okay, up next, please.
Hi, beautiful.
Oh, hi. So I got broken up with right before senior prom.
No.
I think I might have broken up with him, but it doesn't matter. Because my best friend went to prom with him instead. And, you know, like, that's fine. But I'm pretty sure they lost their virginity to each other that night, though.
No, I don't like it.
Yeah. Yeah, I barely remembered until just now.
I'm so sorry.
Wow.
Well, we're here for you in a big way.
Well done. Well done. Welcome to the show. This seems like
oh.
a good night. You look wonderful.
Yes, I've been admiring you all night.
Oh, thank you. I've been admiring you. So my ex-boyfriend's mom asked me out because he hadn't asked me, even though it was the day before prom. So I only had a day to make a dress, and I bleached my hair from purple to blonde, and it all fell out.
No!
And my dad helped me tease it and cover the bald spot, because that's what dads do.
That's so nice. Also, why was that boy such a b- that his mom had to ask you?
Because I think he was seeing someone else.
No.
High school. That's why emo music exists.
Yeah, you're the best. And I'm sorry I said b-. That wasn't right for this gender neutral poly.
It's totally fine.
Prom.
I think it read very clearly in a non-gendered way.
Thank you so much. I'm so sorry that happened, but it's so dope that you said I only had a day to make a dress. Did you guys hear that?
That is pretty rad. There was no world in which you were going to buy a dress, huh?
No.
Well, I didn't have time.
Look at this queen. She's not buying a dress.
Oh, thanks.
It's true.
She's spinning a dress from the ether. She's magic.
It's true. Well done. Well done.
Oh, I've been admiring you too. Just look at your fishbone bow tie.
Thank you. I've been admiring how your tattoo matches your whole outfit.
I'm blessed.
So I skipped my senior prom to hang out with my sophomore boyfriend, and we made out while watching Elephant, the Gus Van Sant movie about the Columbine shooting.
Yeah. I get it so much. I once hooked up to dead ringers. It happens to the best of us.
You've got to do it sometimes.
Yes, but you know what? That sounds like it was probably better than actual prom.
It was. It definitely was.
Isn't it say a lot when you'd rather watch a movie about school shooting than go to prom?
That's most of the time.
Yeah.
Amazing. Wow. Okay. Oh, Andres from Massachusetts, my old friend.
Wow.
How are you, Andres? Good
Thank
to see
you so
you.
Much. Hi. I went with my girlfriend to prom, and we decided to get high before prom, and I got told by the cool kids to sit by myself because I can't handle my weed, I guess. And then me and my girlfriend tried to have sex afterwards, and I just cried.
Oh, that's okay.
Wow. Our first person.
I can't handle my weed either.
I don't mess with that stuff anymore. I always flip out.
Oh my God.
That is officially our first person who ran away after telling his story.
Yep. Give me your hands.
Hi, Lena Dunham.
Hi.
I was scared to have sex at prom, and so I went to the gas station and I bought a gas station sex pill, and it just made me itchy and fall asleep on the prom boat.
The prom boat! Oh, I love a prom boat.
My prom was on a boat, too.
I love it.
I love the gas station sex pill.
How itchy are we talking?
Like to the point where I kind of collapsed in the corner.
You collapsed in the corner?
He collapsed of itchiness, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, wow. Our last
yes.
person here is the final
my
mermaid.
Lena to Lena.
Lena to Lena. Hello.
Hello.
On my prom, I took my boyfriend at the time, but we got married in front of the junior and senior class and all of the faculty. And I had my parents sign a slip saying that I could do so, telling them it was a field trip slip because I was underage at the time. And they only found out that I was married the day after when the faculty and principal was congratulating them on their daughter's marriage at the prom. Also, he also had red hair.
Are you guys divorced?
We are divorced.
Is this true?
This is true.
Wait, this is true. We gotta hold the phone and talk more about this one.
So this mother... tricked her parents into signing a form that said she was allowed to get married because she knew they wouldn't read it, and she said it's for a field trip.
And they never got married, so I was like, what's this all about?
And you got married as a high school junior?
To another redhead, yes.
And can I ask how long the marriage lasted?
It lasted a year and a half, but we got it annulled the next day.
Oh, so...
But it was in you know, we
But spiritually, you remained. Did you get it annulled because your parents were like, stop?
Yes. I guess that's
yes.
why.
You know what? That's actually the best and most inspiring prom story I've heard.
Thanks.
That's one of the craziest stories I've ever heard.
Yeah.
About anything, prom or otherwise. That's incredible.
I just love the knowledge that you're like, my parents are not going to read any of this. Like, that slip could have been like, yes, I have permission to take drugs to Tijuana in my vagina. Like, it could have been anything.
Well, they wouldn't sign anything for that. They'd just be like, go.
Go, do you. Live your life.
Yep.
I love your story.
I love you.
You're so casual and cool about all of this. Wow, incredible. I don't think we're going to top that one. Do not go anywhere when we get back. So much more. Murph, tell them all about it.
Don't you go anywhere. When we get back, we'll be doing more slow dancing. And if I'm lucky, maybe I'll get to second base with a shrimp.
Welcome back. to our 2016 Under the Sea theme, gender fluid poly prom. Everyone's dancing, everyone's having fun. I enjoyed those horror stories, didn't you?
Oh yeah.
Stop it! Stop it, all of you! Get away from each other! Hands off of each other! This is disgusting! I have just come from church, but you can bet your fat behinds I'll be right back there! This is a den of sin!
Excuse me. A prom is a den of sin!
How dare you! Away from each other! Away from each other!
Excuse me, ma'am!
Oh my God, do you know what the Bible says about mermaids?
No.
Nothing! Because if God can't say something nice, he doesn't say anything at all.
Excuse me, ma'am, you're here, you're disrupting our beautiful evening together. I'm not sure why.
I'm here to get my son out.
Your son?
Where is he?
Who is your son?
My son is the human fish.
What? What?
Human fish. This, my boy.
Human fish.
Oh, my boy.
This is your mom versus this isn't your mom.
This is my mom.
Oh. Wow, the mother of the human fish is here. I had no idea. I didn't even know he had a mom.
Of course he has a mom. Don't you?
Yeah, I have a mom. Yeah, I definitely have a mom.
What are you, a clam?
No, I'm a human.
You look like a clam.
I'm a boy in a tuxedo.
Your head looks like a shell. It's too big and it's too small.
What? How can it be both?
I don't know. But I want to get my son out of here. He must have wandered in here by mistake. You see, we were supposed to be at prayer group together.
Human fish, I didn't know you come from a religious family.
Of course he comes from a religious family. Look at him. Look at my boy. Please, please come. Please come. We must go to church and pray away this sin.
Can I just say, first of all, I have a question. You're a fully human woman. He is half man, half fish. So I do have to wonder.
Yes. I had sex with a fish.
It does seem a little odd you're like calling all of us sinners when you did something that's a little...
How dare you? Please get out of here. Let's get away from this clam.
I want to reiterate, I am a human. And I just have to say, tonight is all about inclusiveness, self-determination, really staking your own path in life and owning that. I feel like we should at the very least give the human fish a choice. Human fish, do you want to stay at this prom? Or would you like to leave the prom?
You'd like to leave with your mother, wouldn't you?
Or stay with your old pal, Gethard. You can leave with mom or stay with Gethard.
I want to stay with Gethard.
All right! Human fish wants to stay at the prom. Is that okay? Is that okay?
You'll be sorry. You'll all be sorry.
People are scared.
You'll be sorriest of all.
Wow! Wow!
They're gonna laugh at you. They're all gonna laugh at you!
Wow. Human fish. I think human fish is okay. Human fish, you feeling all right versus you're not feeling all right? You doing good, buddy? Okay. Oh, no! Oh, no! I thought we had avoided that successfully. Human fish, are you okay?
They're all gonna laugh at you!
No, wait, hold on, human fish. This is a whole thing from Carrie, and that's a different movie moment. That's a quote from a different iconic movie. This is Carrie. Remember Carrie? Okay, you got it? You got it now? You're gonna nail this. Remember with the telekinesis? You got this.
Forget it, Jake! It's Little Italy!
No. No, human fish, first of all, that's Chinatown, and also in the quote, it's Chinatown. Little Italy and Chinatown in New York are very close together. That was also wrong. You think you got it now? Carrie, remember with the telekinesis, you pull everything down around you. Exactly, you got it. Nail it, human fish. Take us out.
I want my baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back. Barbecue sauce.
Wait, what is that?
That's Chili's.
Chili's.
That's Chili's. Chili's. That is a Chili's commercial. Human fish, that's not correct. You got it wrong. I'm sorry. Murph, I got to teach this guy about movies. I'm so sorry you had to see
worry,
any of that.
I loved it.
Get us out of here, Murph. No.
Haven't seen that much blood since my trip to the John this morning. Don't go away, because when we come back, we're crowning our own version of a prom queen. Yikes.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, by very exciting news. Bethany, I'm being told Dan is back on Skype.
That's what I hear too.
Dan from California, back on Skype. Now to recap, for anybody who might be joining us late in the show, Dan joined us at the very beginning of our show, asked out a person via our show to prom.
He asked out Alexis. What happened, yes. Dan?
What?
She said yes!
Dan, congratulations! Woo! Well, Dan, happy to help. So happy it worked out. I hope you enjoy your prom.
Thank you. I love you.
So much. Now, that's 3 for 4. 3 of the people who asked people out have received positive answers. I'm being told, Bethany, we got Jack back?
We have Jack from Michigan back.
Jack from Michigan, welcome back to the show.
Yay!
Jack, good to see you.
Good to see you again, Chris.
Now, how's everything going on your end, Jack? You were maybe the most nervous of our 4 callers.
Well, she wasn't watching the first time I asked, so I would just like to ask again.
Okay.
Now that she is watching.
She's definitely watching, so Jack, the floor is yours. Lena, anything. We met Jack before, Lena Dunham. Now that we know she's watching, anything you want to say on Jack's behalf?
Just, I think that Jack is the most kind, funny, respectful person, and that you could not have a better time at the prom with anyone. I'm jealous if you get to go with Jack.
Jack, the floor is yours.
Winter, will you go to prom with me?
Okay, now I'm being told something very special here. Winter is on the phone right now. Quiet, please. Quiet in the studio, please. Winter, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, Winter, I apologize if we created any awkwardness in your life. It's the last thing I want to do. We're having fun here.
I'm here a little bit.
Totally fair. Lena Dunham, a friend of the show. Lena Dunham's here. This is Winter.
Winter, I don't want to put any pressure on your girl, but we don't want to leave Jack hanging.
Yeah, either way, you're not obligated to say yes, but we're just looking for an answer. Do you think you might want to go to prom with Jack?
Yes, I do.
Jack, you got it, Jack. You got it, Jack. Wow. Wow, look at that. 4 for 4.
Jack, are you happy, Jack?
Jack, are you happy?
Yeah, I'm really happy.
That's great. Well, Lena, what a good time. 4 people went for it. 4 people got yeses, and you're right at the heart of that. You're responsible for so much young love in this world.
I feel so lucky, and I just want to let all these people know that you might have a great relationship. It's going to be super fun. It's definitely not going to last your whole life. But
you think it will. It probably won't.
And you feel like it will, mm-hmm. and that's what you're supposed to feel right now. And then around 22, you're going to figure out that they might have just a whole other life that they dreamed of that doesn't include you, and that doesn't have to be a big problem.
Big time.
I'm just kidding. Have a great time at prom.
Murph, get us out of here.
Well, now I know who I'm voting for in the primaries. When we get back, I'll ask a tuna fish for a dance to the music of They Might Be Giants.
Thank you. What an honor. Please keep in touch.
Yeah, it was really...
It's a good time was had by all. Did you have fun, Liz, at the prom?
I had a great time.
Where I'm going now is a place that only mermaids can go. It's a secret place where the door says Lena Dunham. Thank you.
Welcome back. Thank you guys so much. I want to thank Lena Dunham for coming by tonight. It was such a pleasure to have her here. She's so kind and charming and funny. I really enjoy that. And I just wanted to say thanks to everybody for being here. And I know our show is very goofy, and I think that's the way it should be. We're a comedy show and we're absurd. But I will also say that I'm very genuine about how we frame this whole show around the idea of being inclusive to people. And just one thing I wanted to say real quick is one of my least favorite phrases in the English language is when people say, I don't get it. Because they use that phrase to write off whole groups of people. Like, I've heard people say, oh, gay marriage, I don't have anything against anybody. I just don't get it. The trans community, I just don't get it. It's not my thing. And I think that if you're saying that, that means you are excluding people and you're making a point of it. And I just feel like one of the things I've learned in this world that I wanted to speak to seriously tonight, even though this show is so dumb, is that it doesn't matter if you don't get it. That's not
that doesn't preclude you from being kind and loving and accepting. I don't get math. I still know that it has every right to exist and be happy. And I just do so genuinely feel like when we say gender fluid poly prom, we're not kidding about that part. We accept everybody and we wish the world was more that way, and we hope that it is more and more in the future. I mean that. And now I will get off my high horse. I will get off my high horse and I will just say this. Our musical guests tonight, we are so lucky to have them. It is a real thrill and honor. They have written so many songs that I love. They are genuine legends. They are DIY heroes, and I don't think we would exist if they hadn't helped lead the charge on that. Ladies and gentlemen, let's all dance. Let's not worry about anything, because They Might Be Giants are here.
Girl, back against the pit boss again, and now I'm fencing with him with just a fountain pen. You see, I'm dead as a dog, but it's one last stand. And now I'm in these glasses just to be a man. I just wanted my big toe in the soft, soft sand, but now I'm neck deep in the quick, quick. So tell me, are you ready for the bitter truth? Authenticity trip, yes, 200 proof. I keep it in the cupboard with your baby tooth. That's your mom.
Following me.